Hello everyone, welcome you all in my new video. In this video I am going to solve a problem of geophysics related to gravity method, and the problem is from CSIR net December 2019. So the problem is a sphere and a horizontal circular cylinder are both associated with a maximum gravity anomaly of 0.8 milligal. If the sphere and cylinder are both located at twice their present depth, then the value of their maximum gravity anomaly would be respectively. So here, given that for sphere, del g max, which is 0.8 milligal, and for cylinder, del G max, which is 0.8 milligal. So for both, the value of maximum gravity anomaly is 0.8 milligal. Next, if the sphere and the cylinder are both located at twice their present depth. Suppose this is at depth Z1, where the value of Z1 will be Z. You can see in the figure, this is, you can see in figure, this is the depth Z, and this figure is the cross sectional area for both sphere as well as cylinder. So here in the figure, Z is the depth of object, either sphere or horizontal cylinder. Next is R, which is the radius for both horizontal cylinder and sphere. So, and the one more thing, del rho, which means density contrast. So these are the parameter. So in the problem, if the sphere and cylinder both are located at twice their present depth, so that will, if we consider, that will add depth Z1, which means at Z. Now, if the depth will be twice their present depth, that is, now Z2 will be 2Z for cylinder as well as sphere. So Z2 will be 2Z, and R, del rho, these two terms will be constant, that is, does not change. Constant means here does not change, only the value of Z will vary. So this will be Z is equals to Z1, and Z1 is equals to Z, and Z1 is equals to 2Z. Now the formula for gravity anomaly over a buried sphere at depth Z having radius R and density contrast del rho. So the formula will be del GZ, which is equals to 4/3 pi G del rho R cube Z, which is divided by Z square plus X square whole to the power 3/2. So this is the formula for sphere, the value of gravity at this point P over a buried sphere, and the this is the vertical component of gravity. So this component, this will be GZ for sphere. So at point P, the vertical component of gravity, that is GZ, which is given by equation number 1 for sphere, where x is this distance, that is from center, that is at center the value of gravity anomaly will be maximum. So from center to any point where we have to measure the value of gravity, so that point will be the that distance, that is OP, will be your x. So that distance will be x. So this is the formula for maximum gravity anomaly, as in question given that for maximum gravity anomaly. So the value is given, you can see del G max, which is 0.8. So the maximum gravity anomaly will be at point O, that is at this point the gravity anomaly will be maximum. So at point O the value of x will be 0. So the value of x will be 0 because this is just above the center of the sphere. So the value of x will be 0. Therefore del g max, which is equals to 4 by 3 pi g del rho r cube and z divided by z square plus 0 square, so whole to the power 3 by 2. If we solve this, so g max is 0.8, which is equals to 4 by 3 pi g del rho r cube z, and which is divided by z square whole to the power 3 by 2, or we can say 0.8, which is equals to 4 by 3 pi g del rho r cube z divided by z cube. Here you can see if a to the power b to the power c, that will give a to the power b into c. So if b is 2 and c is 3 by 2, so b into c will be 2 into 3 by 2, which means 3. So the power will be 3, or you can say 0.8, which is equals to 4 by 3 pi g del rho r cube 1 by z square. So this is also the expression for maximum gravity anomaly. So this is the equation you have to remember. So this is the expression for maximum gravity anomaly over a buried sphere having density contrast del rho, radius of sphere r, and z is the depth from the surface. Here you can see in the figure, this is the depth z from the surface. This line is your surface. So this is the formula at depth z. So at depth z is equals to z1, the formula will be del g max, which is equals to 4 by 3 pi g del rho r cube 1 by z square. So for z1, and for z2, at z is equals to 2z is equals to z2. So at point z2, or you can write z2 is equals to 2 into z. So del g max will be equals to 4 by 3 पाई जी डेल रो आर क्यू विच इज डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इंटू जेड, 2 इंटू जेड होल स्क्वायर. और यू कैन से इफ वी कंसीडर दिस इक्वेशन नंबर 1, सो दैट विल गिव 4/3 पाई जी. सो दिस इज फॉर जेड 2 एंड दिस इज फॉर जेड 1. सो 4/3 डेल रो आर क्यू 1/4 जेड स्क्वायर, और यू कैन से 1/4 इफ यू टेक 1/4 कॉमन, सो दैट विल गिव 4/3 पाई जी डेल रो आर क्यू इंटू 1/ जेड स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ मैक्सिमम ग्रेविटी एनोमली एट जेड 2, एंड दिस एक्सप्रेशन इज डेल जी मैक्स एट जेड 1. सो हियर यू कैन सी फ्रॉम इक्वेशन 1, सो दिस इज फॉर जेड 1, दैट इज डेल जी मैक्स विच इज एट पॉइंट जेड इज इक्वल्स टू जेड 2 इज इक्वल्स टू 1/4 डेल जी मैक्स एट जेड 1. दैट मीन्स इफ द डेप्थ इज ट्वाइस द प्रीवियस वन, द वैल्यू विल बी 1/4 द वैल्यू ऑफ ग्रेविटी एनोमली, दैट इज मैक्सिमम ग्रेविटी एनोमली विल बी 1/4 ऑफ द प्रीवियस वन. सो द प्रीवियस ग्रेविटी एनोमली इज 0.8, सो दैट विल गिव 0.2. सो फॉर स्फीयर द वैल्यू विल बी 0.2. नाउ दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ मैक्सिमम ग्रेविटी एनोमली फॉर स्फीयर. अगेन वी हैव टू फाइंड the value for cylinder. So from this figure you can see here, so the anomaly value for cylinder, that is del g max, sorry, first you have to know the gravity value. So del g and z, that means vertical component. So in figure at point P, that will be for cylinder and the density contrast is del rho, r is the radius, so for which the formula is 2πg. R is the radius, which means the radius of horizontal cylinder, so 2πg r square del rho z, and which is divided by x square plus z square, and z is the depth of the cylinder and x is the point from this O, that is OP is your x, O is the point of observation, and P is the point of observation. P is the point of observation and O is the point just above the center. For both case, cylinder and sphere. So that OP is your X. Now the maximum will be at point O. So the maximum gravity anomaly will be at O. So at O, OP will be your 0. So maximum gravity anomaly del GZ max, which will be for cylinder 2πG R square del rho Z and divided by 0 plus Z square, because we have to put here in equation number 2, x is equals to 0. So that will give del g z max, which is equals to 2πg r square del rho into 1/z. So this is the formula for cylinder and the formula is maximum gravity anomaly, and this is the formula for gravity anomaly, and the component is vertical at point P. So this equation 2 and equation 3 you have to remember. So del gz max, which is equals to 2 pi g r square del rho into 1 by z. So at z1 is equals to z, the formula will be del gz max, and its value is 0.8, which is equals to 2 pi g r square del rho 1 by z. And at z1 is equals to 2z, that will give del gz max, which is equals to 0.8, that will give 2 pi g r square. So this is not 0.8, this is the value you have to find. So del rho and 1 over 2, 1 over z2, and the z2 is 2z because the depth is twice of the previous one. So that will be 2z. This is for z2 and this is for z1. So del gz z2, which is equals to 1 over 2, 2 pi g r square del rho into 1 over z. And here you can see, this is, if we consider this equation number 3, equation number 4, so that will give del gz at z2, which is equals to half of del gz at z1. So this will give 1 over 2, 0.8, because for z1 the maximum gravity anomaly is 0.8. so del gz for z2, which is equals to 0.4. So this is the value for cylinder, and the value for sphere is 0.2, and the value for cylinder is 0.4. So the option first, that is for cylinder is 0.4 and for sphere is 0.2. So option first will be correct. So you have to remember the formula, and formula for maximum gravity anomaly. So this is the formula for a sphere at point P, and this is the formula for maximum gravity anomaly. Again, this equation 2 and this equation 3. So you have to remember these four equations. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel and share it with your friends. Thank you so much.